Welcome back to SL Chennai Speaks Out. It's a topic that concerns us all. We all have opinions on this, on auto drivers and their behavior and their fares and their meters. Should these fares be hiked? And this is our final round on SL Chennai Speaks Out. It's called Public Punch.
You somehow equated respect for their work with the amount of money they earned. I think the problem lies not in the amount of money that they earn. I think the problem lies in the fact that we don't respect them as individuals. And I'm willing to pay the extra fare if they are willing to learn how to communicate with their passengers. I'm willing to pay the extra 3-4 rupees.
It's not how much you want to pay, but how they interact with us, how we interact with them. It takes two to tangle. You extend the hand. You be nice to them. I guarantee you, nowhere.
But that hand should first go to the meter and switch it on. Right?
Maybe. Maybe you should do that, because then you show that you trust the
Maybe
meter.
You're saying the passenger should switch on the meter.
Why not? I think you trust the meter. Most of the passengers don't trust the meter. That's the problem.
All right, let me ask you another question. What is the percentage of meters that are tampered?
I think less than 5%, less than 3% today.
Show of hands, how many in the audience believe that is true? Only 5% of the meters are tampered.
Because electronic meters cannot be tampered.
30%.
Most of the auto drivers don't put the meter.
So let's have a show of hands. Let's have a show of how many of you in the audience believe that. Put up your hands if you think that only 5% of the meters in auto are tampered. How many of you believe that much more than 5% are tampered? Reality check, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a reality check. Perception is reality, but sometimes it's wrong.
Don't you think giving them a reasonable hike would even make the ugly drivers into good and better drivers?
Every one of you, I can tell you, you have your own limitations, your own difficulties in the house. For that, you are not going to come. Please don't compare the private life with public. This is a public transport, sir. Whether they make money, whether they earn money, it is immaterial for public. So far, we are concerned.
So auto drivers are not freedom fighters. They are earning. They want to earn their living. They want to earn their living.
I think they are confusing between public service and public utility.
Yeah, public utility and public service, they are two separate things.
I think both of us are getting confused.
But that doesn't mean they should demand.
All right, don't demand.
They must stick to the rules.
That's what he may say.
We ask them to change the rules so they can follow the rules.
The point is that they are not following the rules because the rules are outdated and need to be changed.
Not outdated, sorry.
2007, sir.
Before
that,
1996. You know why the food inflation? And the every auto. Anybody has checked? No public knows now. They are given undertaking on that day. It will be published in the front. If anybody auto is having in the city,
let's ask the auto drivers. You are undertaking kuttirukinga la vandha fair hike panumbodhu
neenga meter pottu dhaan ottringa auto letters
vandha auto driver vandu ellame bad ivanga vandu ellame auto driver la ellam thridam ivangalude enna adu na ippo kuda varumbodhu oru ponna free ah kuda vittu vandha
adhu vera
inga varumbodhu vittu varan
board irukudanga
oru oru
board irukudanga let him answer
avrukku theriyum 61 rupees per petrolum oilum idhula eltam solradhu paandu bazar poradhukku 35 minutes இந்த 35 நிமிஷத்தில் இவருடைய பெட்ரோல் எவ்வளோ ஆகுதுங்கிறீங்களா? ஒரு மனசாட்சி இல்லாமல் 25 ரூபா கொடுத்துட்டு போகிறேன். உங்களுக்கு ஒரு எண்ணம் வரணும். என்னப்பா இவ்வளோ டிராஃபிக்கில் இந்த வண்டி ஓட்டுவார். இன்ச்சு இன்ச்சாக நவருது. அவருக்கே தெரியும். ஏன்னா அவர் நின்று பார்க்குற கால் கணக்கு நின்று பார்க்குறாரு. வண்டி இன்ச்சு இன்ச்சாக நடந்து போகுது. எல்டாம் சொல்கிறது பாண்டி பஜாரை பொறுத்து அந்த 35 நிமிஷத்தில் அந்த ஆட்டோ டிரைவர் என்ன எனர்ஜி ஆகிருக்கும், எவ்வளோ பெட்ரோல் செலவாகிருக்கும், அவன் எத்தனை டைம் அந்த வண்டி ஆஃப் பண்ணியிருப்பான், எத்தனை டைம் குனிஞ்சு அடிச்சிருப்பான், எத்தனை டைம் கீரை மாற்றிருப்பான். அப்போ நாங்களும் உங்களை மாதிரி மனிதன் தானே.
Mr. Ramaswamy, that's a very valid point. He's talking about you're called Traffic Ramaswamy. You know better than most people how traffic crawls in Chennai.
Yes.
He's saying the traffic moves inch to inch by inch, and especially peak hours in certain areas, congested areas. So there's a lot more petrol. Don't strictly go by the mileage of an auto. There's a lot more petrol that is used.
All those things considered, only figure that has to be fixed. Don't change now.
How many new vehicles are added to Chennai every day, sir? What is the vehicle explosion?
Traffic has gone up threefold,
fourfold. Sir, every day, Mr. Ramaswamy, you're aware, every day 900 vehicles are added to Chennai. There's a vehicle explosion.
1,200.
Okay, 1,200. There's a vehicle explosion here, so traffic crawls. So what he is saying is that much more petrol is used.
I don't deny that. That's what I'm telling.
But you still want the price to be very fixed at 1 rupee or 2 rupees.
You decide once for all and
that
fix
I
the
agree
rules.
With you, sir. There's no disagreement at all. You want them to change the behavior. I am with 100%. Now we are talking about focused on pricing.
So
like
96 level, Mr. Ramaswamy, your point is that In 96, they gave an undertaking, right? That if they revise the auto fares, they will put the meter.
Once again,
14 rupees for first 2 kilometers, 6 rupees for additional kilometer. Neenga vandu 20 rupees kekringalingla? 20 rupees for the first 2 kilometers, 10 rupees for additional kilometer. That is the demand. That is the demand now. And the other increase pandradhukku appuram neenga meter poduvingla? Nariya pe appu kuda poda matanga.
Meter podalana?
Neenga solunga.
Na meter podalana? அரசாங்கம் ஒண்ணு இருக்கு இல்லீங்களா?
என்ன அரசாங்கம்
இருக்கு? பொதுமக்கள் வருங்க. பொதுமக்கள் வரும்போது என்ன கேக்குறீங்க? நீங்க ஒருத்தர் வராரு அங்க இருந்து.
இல்ல பொதுமக்கள் என்ன நினைக்கறாங்கன்னா நீங்க வந்து ஃபேர் ஹைக் பண்றதுக்கு அப்புறம் கூட நீங்க மீட்டர் போட மாட்டீங்க.
கட்டாயம் போடுவோம். கட்டாயமா போடுவோம்.
அதே மாதிரி நீங்க 96 ல சொல்லிருக்கீங்க.
கட்டாயமா போடுவோம்.
நீங்க 2008 வரைக்கும் you don't expect him to do it at 2008 when the price has not been changed.
Still 96
they don't done. 7 days below. Let's hear them out. நீங்க சொல்லுங்க.
அதாவது போர்டு வந்து 14 ரூபா 6 ரூபான்னு போர்டு இருக்கணும் எல்லா வண்டியும் ஒரு வழி இருக்கா சொல்ல சொல்லுங்க போ
ஆட்டோ டிரைவர்ஸ் ஆர் ரெடி டு யூசிங் மீட்டர்
ஓய் ஓய் நீ ஏன் போட மாட்டீங்க
ஐ ஆம் ரெடி டு யூசிங் மீட்டர்
தே ஆர் கிவன் கிவன் ஃப்ரீ தி போர்டு
லெட் ஹர் ஸ்பீக் லெட் ஹர் ஸ்பீக்
ராமசாமி ஒன் மினிட் ஒன் மினிட்
தே ஆர் தி மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் காம்போனென்ட் ஆன் தி ஷோ ஐ வான்ட் டு ஹியர் देम அவுட் ஐ வான்ட் டு ஹியர் தி ஆட்டோ டிரைவர் நீ சொல்லுங்க
சார் வி ஆர் ரெடி டு யூசிங் மீட்டர் நவ இஃப் தி கவர்மெண்ட் கிவ்ஸ் 10 ரூபீஸ் பர் கிலோமீட்டர் We are ready. We need, because the reason, some reason. Before 8 years before, 8 years before, they are around 6 rupees per kilometer. At that time, 32 rupees per liter petrol. Now 62 rupees, 100% excess. But we are not increasing 12 rupees. We are asking only 10 rupees per kilometer. The road also, more difficulty. Damages roads and traffic jams, you know about well about the traffic jam. Okay. Definitely, I say all that is ready to use meter if you, the government give 10 rupees.
Okay.
I am ready. All drivers are ready.
Sir, price increase engirade ella commodities kondu engalukku undu ungalukku adu irukke
one more reason
but neenga unmaya vaichaka unmaya vaichaka kaathala anga enga pogama maritime irundhaaka neenga sampadhik mudiyum price ipo
one more
no but answer one second he has asked you a specific question now he says the petrol price was 30 32 rupees then when this rate was fixed Now with the oil, he has to pay 62 rupees per liter. All he is asking for is a 6 rupee hike for the first 2 kilometers and 4 rupees for every additional kilometers extra. What is the problem in granting that, sir?
I am telling you, price increases not only in Madras city. In other places also, Bangalore, Mysore, other places also.
We are concerned about Chennai.
They are living happily with that.
So we are concerned about Chennai.
No. Sir, Delhi drivers, Pune drivers and Kerala drivers, sir. They use the same petrol, same price. We go from, for an example, we are started from the auto from Trivandrum to Central. We are collecting 150 to 180 maximum. Then again, we will return back completely empty. Other states not like this. They are going and standing the same place. Here, if in Chennai, you stand in front of the central station, policeman will call 500 rupees. There is no parking board. In all other cities, the people's all drivers going and standing the same place and making another trip.
Yeah, when they are happy, when those auto drivers in other places,
Chennai policemen not allowed.
He's saying the auto goes empty.
Not allowed. Road is not enough to stand the auto. So many problems.
He has to pay. He's saying, see, on the one hand, we talk about the police not imposing fines.
The meter will show 150 rupees. Then where will we stand by our auto?
Mr. Lakshmanan, these are genuine grievances.
Then
we have
return
to
back
them
empty. How many kilometers we are running?
These are genuine
Who
grievances.
For the money?
These are genuine grievances of auto drivers as reasonable people. We have to hear them out. Now, we are talking about the policemen not imposing fines. He's talking about the policemen asking for bribes. To stand in a place, the policeman demands money.
No, why you stand there?
We are ready.
Where else does he get a passenger?
He didn't say quiet.
They have been permitted in all the street corners. Nowadays, don't say.
Give evidence.
Please.
But we know there's a parking issue everywhere.
In Central, he cannot go and park and pick up a ride. No, sir. Prepaid only.
Why stand on the road?
Mr. Ramaswamy, please understand. Only allowed autos can go for a prepaid race.
There is a clique in Central which will prevent him from taking a fare back. So he has to come back to Central. In fact, that is what destroys the fabric of this city's auto culture.
Yeah, Dr. Mahalingam has done a PhD on this subject and he knows where what he's talking. Mr. Lakshminarayan, you want to answer that?
Research is different.
No, no, Mr.
Actual fact, difficulty is different.
No.
You can do so many things. They have constructed so many buildings based on research. But everything is failure, they themselves accept. Research is no good.
But are you reality must go. How can you what you have to do?
That you have to give. You must see on the spot. Research I can also give. So this you can do.
You can't rubbish
that,
in this.
That, all that right. will not work out.
Okay.
That is my point.
All right, fair enough.
Real difficulty at the auto level, you cannot research.
So what do you have to say about the genuine...
Give that.
Mr. Ramasamy, what do you have to say about the genuine grievances of auto drivers? How do you hope to redress those grievances?
That is, even now, I am not objecting any raise. That is different.
The auto owner asking 200 rupees per day.
சட்டங்களை கடைபிடிச்சி நாலு பேர் ஏற்ற மாட்டோம் அஞ்சு பேர் ஏற்ற மாட்டோம் இந்த மாதிரிலாம் சட்டங்களை ஃபாலோ பண்ணி வரான்னு சொன்னா நானே ஏற்ற நான் ஃபைட் பண்றேன்
போட்டுக்காக வாட் வி ஹேவ் பீன் டெல்லிங் டீச்சிங் ஆட்டோ டிரைவர்ஸ் நாட் டு ப்ளே
யூ ஷட் ஆக்ட்
ஆல்ரெடி வித் தி கவர்மெண்ட்
யூ ஆர் நாட் டுயிங் ஐ அம் டுயிங்
என்ஃபோர்ஸ்மென்ட் வித் தி கவர்மெண்ட்
விவியன் ஹி ஜஸ்ட் டோல்ட் தட் people like we should fall pity common people should fall pity on the auto rickshaw fellows. Why can't the owners themselves fall pity on the auto rickshaw fellows?
We are asking you to give them what they deserve and nothing more.
See, in Pune I have seen the rate is immediately raised when the petrol price is hiked, and the RTO is responsible, not the government or anybody. They the passengers.
RTO is part of the government, sir.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have to go to the high end of the government is what he's saying.
He has given the permission to announce a hike. So there is no...
locally they are able to take
decentralize, sir. So that's what should happen.
Yeah.
If as long as you're hiking the rates, nobody is going to bargain, no one is going to fight.
I am going to be a graduate of engineering studying 4 years of 8th semester, and how much do I get? Being an engineer, 20,000 rupees.
An auto driver, if you think you can make
probably yes,
a day.
I would go and drive
sir,
an auto.
I will do it,
getting,
sir. If you really truly believe, I want you to take up the profession.
If I'm getting 30,000,
if you think an auto driver can make 1,000 rupees,
yes.
Take that profession for God's sake.
Okay,
I will
yes,
do it.
I would definitely if so I'm getting 30. But
you know that
why do you have
don't
to
don't exaggerate
hike?
The case is what
okay,
I'm
okay,
saying.
Let me bounce off Dr. Mahalingam, the expert on the subject. Dr. Mahalingam, how many auto drivers make 1,000 rupees a day profit?
None. Our research. Okay, I cannot. Our research shows that most of them make about 200 to 300 a day, if they can. And he's probably, they're talking about total revenue, even that doesn't go reach to 1,000, probably 1% of the population.
I am personally from Bombay. From there, I stay at Kulaba. From there, Kulaba, if I were to go to Baikala, that's the same distance from Egmore to RK Salai. It would cost me around 70 bucks. Whereas in Chennai, from Egmore to RK Salai, it would cost me 100 bucks. There's a difference of 30 bucks. Now, you want to tell
it's
me the needs...
Probably because you don't speak in Tamil, so they know that you're not from here.
No, I've gone with many Tamilian friends as well. So I think so they can bargain in Tamil as well. So you want to say that the needs of Tamilian auto drivers is more than that of Bombay. And mind you, over there, they are driving taxis which consume more petrol. And also, I got a second question as well. Now, today, you say that these people... you need to increase the fare so that you can increase this condition of living. What guarantee do you give me that tomorrow they won't ask for a further hike?
Unlike bus drivers, unlike organized movement, unorganized movement, there are 50,000 independent contractors, okay? There are several of them who do good. There are few of them who do bad. Naturally, we see the bad things more than the good. But it has to, the change is not either with
sir,
me or, change is not with me or you. It is also with the government, which we want as the auto drivers and the people who want to increase the price. We want the government to enforce with iron hand
sir,
to make
you
sure
spoken,
people who don't put the meter, you put them in the jail
the
for God's sake.
You make the pricing, open pricing. Who is the government to fix the price? Let it be free pricing. Open
that
market.
That can be considered. I agree with that.
Open market. The auto driver, if I flag an auto, he says a rate, I say no. The next auto, I say. But if the cartel comes, 3-4 of them come together, they hold the place, say, no, I will fix the price. That is where the problem lies.
How many of you believe that there should be no fixed fare? It should be open to the driver and the passenger. How many of you believe that cannot happen? That should not happen.
Only problem is, this crowd will not guarantee the auto driver another passenger back. And if you cannot guarantee him, he will not be able to apply for you.
Fair enough. That's a
I did try one thing. I asked an auto driver to put a banner saying honest meter. I said you will get a lot more fare.
Yes.
But he could not do it all the time because there are other elements which will not allow him to ply with a boat.
Right, but that's a reasonable view. The traffic police had issued cards, complaint cards, where people could write the auto number and give details. They gave about, I think, 10,000 cards. I'm told they just got only about less than 100 complaints.
Absolutely.
So the public, even when they're given an opportunity to complain, you don't complain.
I have given.
But how many people have complained?
No, I am getting.
What is the ratio of the cards issued and the complaints received?
Yeah, fine has been intimated to me, if I write it. People are not using it properly.
Generally, how many auto drivers actually behave well with women passengers? I'd like to know.
Almost 50% of them behave well.
Okay.
50%. 50%
don't. Okay. What do they do? When you say they don't behave well, what do they do?
Like sometimes I have faced this. The last time when the meters was made in compulsory point, me and my mother, when we had to travel from one place to other, she was not feeling well. We asked them to turn on the meter, but the auto drivers weren't ready to turn on the meters. And then we let him go. I told my mother, no, we have to. Why should they? There's a law. We have to abide by it. And then another auto man came. He also didn't abide by like what we told. Turn on the meters. He didn't want to turn on the meters. And then we didn't have any other go. We had to like fall for it.
So I know families which have left their daughter at 9 o'clock at night, asking the auto driver to drop her in the relative's place.
Are you saying auto drivers have never abused passengers?
Never is too much of that. I say 80% of the auto drivers. Other than the fare, I think all of us, including myself.
No, you can't go back. You said earlier 60% don't put on the meters. 60% fleece, you said earlier. Now
right.
What are you saying? 80%.
I did. Now what I said is, I agree with that. What I am saying is, other than the fare. I guarantee you 80% of the auto drivers
so you're saying 60
will behave.
One second.
60% is about the fare.
As a representative of the auto drivers, in a sense, you are saying 60% fleece and 20% misbehave.
No. I think you are putting a word in my mouth.
No, I'm not.
You need to hear me out,
yeah.
And then maybe you can kind of translate it in
all
a way.
All right, I'll hear you out right now.
Okay. What I'm saying is, other than the meter problem that people may face, which I also do face, 80% of the auto drivers, you will never hear a complaint about misbehaving with the public. Meter, they will haggle. Okay? But 80...
How many ride autos drunk?
Huh?
How many ride autos drunk, you tell me?
How many?
How many ride the autos in a drunken state?
I know of the... If I were to make a sampling, I would say only about 10% max.
20%.
Max. Max. People.
Which means 60 plus 20 plus 10, 90% of the auto drivers have some problem or the other. Either they fleece or they drive drunk.
Looking
at it in a wrong way.
No,
you're adding 60 plus 20 plus 10. Off that 60,
right,
maybe
okay.
20% and off that 20, maybe 10%.
He has given you a right explanation.
When MPs are raising the salary in the Parliament House, why not they increase the fare to the people?
Traffic speeds in 92 was probably 20 kilometers an hour. Today it's 12 to 14 kilometers an hour average. During peak times, it is less than 5 to 6 kilometers an hour. Number two, the fixed cost of an auto is 60% of the total cost. So when it takes, as he said, 45 minutes to go from Eldams Road to Pondy Bazaar, the fixed cost is running. Unless you charge duration also, time is, there are two legs of a fare, time and distance. When you make somebody go on one leg, he will run badly. When time and distance are charged, you will find the right behavior that you want.
I concur with you, Mahal.
In fact, if you want a short distance, look into your watch and pay him by 2 rupees a minute. 2 rupees a minute you pay, that will cover his fixed cost and there will not be an argument.
2008 level, the auto per rate, 1,20,000. 20,000. Now, 1,50,000. 52, 56. 20 rupees minimum, 10 rupees kilometer kurta, nanga 80%, 85% meter put a ready.
How many of you in the audience feel that auto fare should be hiked? Put up your hands. How many of you feel that auto fare should not be hiked? This house believes that auto fares should not be hiked. Well, perhaps the term honest auto driver has become an oxymoron in our society, in our city. The final word would rest with the transport ministry in the state based on a report that will be submitted by Anna University. But perhaps even if the fares are hiked, then it's time for auto drivers to actually get their act together to ensure that they ply only with meters, that they don't refuse to ply short distances, they put on the meters and meters are not tampered. But that's all. If you have a point of view, you're welcome to email us, feedback@ndtv-hindu.com. From all of us on the SL Chennai Speaks Out team, thank you for joining us. We'll see you next week at the same time.